Proteins in our body are made up of different amino acids, some of which can be synthesized in our body, while others are only acquired from our diet. For example, phenylalanine is an essential amino acid found mainly in meat and dairy. After consumption, our body recycles an estimated 10 to 20% of this phenylalanine utilized in our own protein synthesis, while the rest are metabolized into another amino acid called tyrosine by a phenylalanine hydroxylase enzyme. This process is important to ensure that our body has the appropriate levels of both amino acids for normal function. However, around 1 in 10,000 people have a genetic mutation in a specific gene on chromosome 12, leading to a deficiency in this enzyme. This leads to an autosomal recessive disorder called phenylketonuria, also known as PKU, that was discovered by Dr. Asbjørn Følling in 1935. Individuals with PKU have a decreased or inhibited conversion of phenylalanine into tyrosine, causing phenylalanine to be instead converted into phenylpyruvic acid that accumulates and becomes toxic to the brain. As such, PKU patients typically develop intellectual disability, epilepsy, seizures, eczema, light pigmentation of skin, eyes, and hair, as well as a musty odour. Thankfully, in 1953, Dr. Horst Bickel and his team discovered that this toxic accumulation of phenylpyruvic acid could be minimized by placing PKU patients on a low phenylalanine diet from birth. This decrease in consumed phenylalanine would then decrease the amount of phenylpyruvic acid produced, preventing its accumulation and thus allow patients to develop normally with minimal neurocognitive and developmental issues. As such, the early diagnosis and intervention of PKU became important to prevent irreversible damage. In the early 1960s, doctors began to conduct a simple ferric chloride test to detect the levels of phenylpyruvic acid excreted in the urine. If a high concentration was detected, the test would turn blue-green, indicating that the individual has PKU. However, this test had serious limitations. For one, PKU in young infants could not be detected until several weeks after birth. By then, toxic accumulation of phenylpyruvic acid would have already been reached, making it too late to prevent its toxic effects on the brain. Not only that, but older individuals would also receive a false negative result if the concentration of phenylpyruvic acid was below approximately 20 milligrams per 100 milliliters of urine, despite the individual actually having PKU. Having learned about the effects of PKU and the limitations of the urine ferric chloride test, Dr. Robert Guthrie became inspired to develop a more sensitive diagnostic test to allow a better utilization of the low phenylalanine diet. He had discovered in his previous cancer research that the growth of a bacteria called Bacillus subtilis in a minimal culture medium could be inhibited by beta-2 phenylalanine. This inhibition could then be prevented by the addition of phenylalanine or phenylpyruvic acid to allow bacterial growth. Using this knowledge, in 1961, he developed a simple yet effective measure of phenylalanine levels in the blood, now commonly known as the Guthrie test. The Guthrie test is quite simple, requiring only a few drops of blood from the patient that is pricked onto a thick absorbent filter paper named the Guthrie card. The blood sample is then dried, hole punched out, and taken to a lab where it is placed onto the surface of an agar culture medium, along with other samples of known phenylalanine concentrations. This agar contains the bacteria as well as the compound inhibiting it. Therefore, if the individual has PKU, the phenylpyruvic acid present in their blood would prevent the inhibition of the bacteria, allowing it to grow. After 16 hours, the level of bacterial growth is then used to diagnose the presence and severity of PKU by comparing it with the known concentration samples. This method proved to be more sensitive, detecting an extra 3 positive cases of PKU in a group of 3,118 individuals compared to the previous urine ferric chloride test. Thus, the Guthrie test allowed more PKU patients to be correctly diagnosed and put onto the low phenylalanine diet for treatment to prevent symptoms that would have otherwise persisted throughout life. Nowadays, while the testing for PKU has evolved to use other methods such as tandem mass spectrometry and automated fluorometric analysis, Guthrie's blood screening test remains an important turning point in medical history. It was the first mandatory genetic testing implemented for newborns worldwide, and its success became the stepping stone towards normalizing universal newborn screening for other genetic diseases, allowing for early detection and intervention for hundreds of thousands of individuals.